All right, today we're going to read another Seymour Simon book called Penguins. And this book's focus is on many details about penguins, including their physical features, swimming abilities, mating habits, development from hatching to adulthood, and the threats to their existence. Penguins are champion swimmers and divers, but they are not fish, and they are not aquatic mammals such as the dolphin. Penguins are birds because they have feathers, and only birds have feathers. Like birds, they lay their eggs and raise their chicks on land, but they don't look or fly like most other birds. Instead, they seem to fly through the water, and they spend much of their lives at sea. All penguins live in the southern hemisphere, from frozen Antarctica to the warmer waters of the Galapagos Islands near the equator. Penguins are defenseless, so they usually live in and out of void places, safe from most enemies. Since penguins are very social, their nesting areas, called rookeries, may contain thousands of pairs of birds crowded up against one another, such as these king penguins. Even at sea, penguins usually swim and feed in groups. The penguin colonies on Antarctica are huge, containing 20 million or more penguins at a time during the year. So on this first page, Seymour Simon introduces you to the penguins, much as he did with frogs and dolphins. What are some things he tells you about penguins on this page? Penguins have big heads and short, thick necks. Some penguins have crests and differently colored heads and bills. Black, blue, or gray feathers usually cover the upper parts of their bodies. Their legs are set low on their bodies and they waddle from side to side as they walk. If people waddled like penguins, they would fall over easily. But penguins rarely seem to trip and fall down. The 17 penguin species live in many different places, but all penguins feed at this sea emperor penguin. Some dive as deep as 1,500 feet to find food. Their main meals are small fish and squid. Antarctic penguins also feed on krill. A penguin's tongue and throat have stiff, backward-facing barbs that help grip slippery food and keep it from sliding out. When a penguin swallows food underwater, it also ingests salt water. Special glands drain the salt water into the penguin's nose. The salt water runs off its nose when the penguin surfaces. And we can see a penguin surfacing right here in this picture. Paddle-like flippers, a short wedge-shaped tail, and webbed feet help make penguins good swimmers. Some penguins spend 3/4 of their lives in the water, occasionally for months at a time. Penguins have a streamlined body shape in the water. A mid-sized penguin can slice through the water like an arrow cutting through the air. The penguin hunches its head into its shoulders and presses its feet close to its body against its tail to help steer. In the water, the motion of the penguin's flippers resembles the wing movements of birds in flight. Their heavy, solid bones help penguins stay underwater and keep them from bobbing to the surface. Penguin eyes are large and help them see clearly underwater as well as on land. Penguins can stay underwater for 10 to 15 minutes before coming to the surface to breathe. Most penguins can swim 5 or 6 miles per hour. However, some can put on a blazing burst of speed of as much as 15 miles per hour. The fastest a person has ever run in 1 hour is a little over 13 miles. Even though penguins spend much of their lives at sea, they all return to land to lay eggs. The season for mating depends upon the penguin species and habitat. In temperate zones, breeding season is often in the spring. During the mating season, penguins head for a rookery. When he is ready to mate, the male stands, arches his back, and stretches out his flippers. He makes loud calls and waves his head and flippers. He bows, struts about, and may offer a rock as a gift. If fights break out, the males use their bills and flippers to hit their rivals. When penguins, like the king penguins on the left, find their mates, they bond by touching necks and slapping each other on the back with their flippers. By singing to each other, they learn to recognize each other's voice. A penguin may stay with its mate for years or as long as the pair has chicks together. In about 4 days, most kinds of penguins lay 2 eggs. Both parents take turns sitting on the eggs for about 4 or more weeks, depending on the species of penguin. During incubation, the brood pouch, an area of skin on the lower abdomen, becomes swollen and warm. The chick uses its egg tooth, a small point on the tip of the bill, to break through the eggshell. Within a few weeks, the chick grows feathers that provide insulation against the cold. While their parents search for food at sea, chicks often stay in groups called creches for safety and warmth. Chicks beg for food from any passing adult or even other chicks. So adults identify their own chicks like their king penguin chicks by recognizing their distinctive calls. When a chick pecks around a parent's bill, the parent feeds its partially digested food from the parent's stomach. When chicks are ready to leave the nest, they shed their feathers and develop waterproof feathers. Now they are fledglings. Before long, they will make their first journey to sea to build up their body fat. So we can see an adult penguin right here and a bunch of chicks, ultimately, because they all have that kind of puffy fur still. What are some things about penguins and their babies that remind you of other living things? How are chicks and fledglings different? Besides the lack of food and bad weather, penguin chicks have to contend with many dangers, particularly from predators such as mustelids, rats, dogs, pigs, gulls, sheathbills, and giant petrels. But the skua, an Antarctic seabird, is a chick's worst enemy. When in flight, a skua can pick up and swallow a small chick in a single gulp. On the ground, a powerful skua can catch and drag a good-sized chick away from the protection of the colony. Adult penguins have no natural enemies on land, but at sea they are preyed upon by leopard seals, killer whales, fur seals, sea lions, and sharks. A leopard seal, right here on the right, swims along the edges of the ice pack or hides under ice floes, waiting for penguins to dive into the water. Emperors, the largest penguins in the world, stand up to 4 feet high and weigh as much as 100 pounds. The emperors spend cold, windy winters on the open Antarctic ice, 100 or more miles inland. To stay warm, emperors clump together in huge huddled masses. They take turns moving to the inside of the group, where they are partly protected from the frigid winds that howl at more than 100 miles per hour along the ice. After a courtship of several weeks, a female emperor lays a single egg and leaves it atop the feet of her mate. She immediately departs for the distant sea to feed. For about 65 days, through blinding storms and sometimes below freezing temperatures, the father balances the egg on his feet and keeps it warm by covering it with his brood pouch. Finally, the mothers return at time the chicks are hatching. They take over the feedings and the males head to sea. 7 or 8 weeks later, the chicks are large enough to make their trip. King penguins are second in size and only to emperors. A king is almost 3 feet tall and can weigh nearly 35 pounds. It lives on the cold, rocky coast of islands surrounding Antarctica. The king penguin has golden orange swatches on its neck and around its head, a white belly, and a blue-black back. Kings don't waddle the way most penguins do. Instead, they run fairly quickly on their feet. Nesting colonies of up to 10,000 kings from onshore. Each penguin keeps its neighbor at its exact but close distance away. If a neighbor gets too close, it gets a nasty slap from a flipper or a jab from the beak. Seymour Simon has written words underneath some of the photographs in this book. Under this photo, it says, King Penguin. This is a label or a caption. It tells you what's in the photo. Gentoo penguins can grow as tall as 30 inches and can weigh up to 13 pounds. Their colorful orange bill sets them apart from other penguins. Also, no other penguin has a big tail. Most gentoos live in large colonies along the coast of Antarctica. Gentoos stay with their their mates throughout the year. Mating pairs usually build nests of pebbles on bare ground. Year after year, they may return to the same inland nest to lay their two eggs. So we can see a Gentoo penguin right here. We can see those pebbles that they were talking about. Pebbles is another word for rocks, small rocks. Macaroni penguins right over here get their name from their long orange, yellow, and black feathery crests that rise above their eyes. They were named after a macaroni dandy, a hairstyle that was fashionable in the 18th century. Macaronis stand about 27 inches high and weigh about 19 pounds. They live around Antarctica, mostly on South Georgia, Crozet, Kruglin, and Heard Islands. Breeding season for macaronis start in December when mating pairs lay two different size eggs. The first egg is half the size of the second egg and usually does not hatch. Rockhoppers, the smallest of the Antarctic penguins, are slightly taller than 20 inches and weigh only 5.5 pounds. They live among the macaronis. Like the macaronis, they have feathered crests on their head and have similar nesting and breeding habits. But rockhoppers are more aggressive than macaronis. Over here, we have the macaroni penguins. Adélie penguins were named after the wife of a Dumont d'Urville, one of the early explorers of the Antarctic. Adélies are small penguins, about 27 inches in height and weigh about 10 or 11 pounds. Adélies spend the harsh Antarctic winter months near the outer edges of the ice pack, where it is slightly warmer. They often stay at sea, resting in groups on a pack ice and icebergs. As summer approaches, they breed on the coast or on barren island beaches. Adélie rookeries range in size from less than 100 to hundreds of thousands of chicks. Chinstrap penguins are the same size as Adélies. They get their name from a thin black line that circles their chin, like a strap on a helmet. They breed in slightly warmer waters on islands off the coast of Antarctica. One of the largest colonies on Deception Island may have up to 1 million chinstraps. Chinstraps are among the boldest and most aggressive of all penguins. And over here, we can see the label for the Adélie penguin right here, or caption. Other penguin species. Royal penguins have yellow, orange, and black crests. Royals are found only on rocky Macquarie Island in the Pacific Ocean south of New Zealand. They are the largest of the crested penguins. Erect crested penguins have long spiky feathers that stand straight up from their heads. They live in the sub-Antarctic regions of southern New Zealand. Blue or little or fairy penguins are the smallest of all penguins. Blues stand 16 inches high and weigh only 2 pounds. They live in the warmer waters around Australia, Tasmania, and New Zealand. Megalanic penguins, the largest of the warm weather penguins seen here, live on the stormy and rocky shores of southern Argentina and Chile. Yellow-eyed penguins, the third largest penguins, have yellow-orange cat-like eyes. They live along the coastal shores of New Zealand and neighboring islands. Seymour Simon describes some different kinds of penguins on these last several pages. I want you to talk, maybe with a partner, about something interesting you learned about one of these penguins. Despite the harsh weather, the penguins that live in and around Antarctica, such as the chinstrap penguins, survive in large numbers. But penguins that live in climates that are more temperate are not as fortunate. Some kinds are in danger of becoming extinct. There are only a few thousand Galapagos penguins left because weather and oceans changing, known as El Nino, have depleted the numbers of fish that they eat. South of Australia, only a few thousand Fiordland penguins remain due to the lack of fish. The development of coats, overfishing, and pollution have also affected the penguin population. Pollution in ocean waters reduces the ability of penguins to lay their eggs that hatch successfully. Some researchers estimate that tens of thousands of penguins are killed each year by oil spills. Along the Australian and New Zealand coasts, cats, dogs, and other animals feed on penguins' chicks. Each penguin species struggles in a different way to survive. By learning more about penguins, we can begin to understand how to help them and other endangered sea animals to survive in our changing world. As we finish this book, I want you to think about some of the dangers that penguins face and what we can do to help them. And then in the back of Seymour Simon's book, we have his glossary and index again. And then we also have some pictures of the other books that he has written, and also on the back of the cover.